Many fisheries professionals don't like this at all. Say, why am I making fisheries look funny? But people are hungry. Do you need to get a certificate before you can do this? No, I want to hear you. Do you need that? So let's go ahead. Now, where's the male fish? Let me. This one. No, leave it down. Let me hold it. Now, this is a male. Bring the basin. Now, this is a male fish. Now, how do you know it's a boy? Boys are a little bit slender. They don't have round stomach like our women. And then under the male is something that looks like a sac, like a testis. But it's not the testis. Go put it there so that, okay, you beam in it, so that it can show a male. A male has a hole for poo-poo, excrement, and this sac that looks like a testis. But the testis is inside the fish. Now, how do you know it's a matured boy? You know, there are some boys that are 14-year-old where they look big, passive, you know. The only thing that I don't have beards. So how do you know a boy that is less than 9 months, because you are matured when you are 9 months? How do you know a boy that is not just a Greek? This testis, this sac, will cross the fin. That shows he is matured. Is that okay? So how do you know when you go to the market to buy a fish? Even though he's very big, it might be an immatured, oversized boy. You need a man, is that not? So look for a fish that sac cross the leg. You remember, Abby? Either cross to the right or the left. That shows a matured boy. Is that okay? So let's look at the girl now, the female. The eggs are coming, right? Hold on, no, let me finish. Now, for the lady, I won't say girl because girls are immature. You can see the tummy is big. And it's like, can you see? The egg is about coming out. Oh, okay. Now the egg is about coming out because I injected. Now, in our own case, you see there's no sac. There are two holes, one for poo-poo and one for the egg. That's not fair now. But for the sake of everybody, she has to bear the the wahala, you know. So what we're going to do now that we know she's ripe, what we now do is to now kill the male. So watch what they do while I talk. Can I be? They do it here. After all, the salmon ground was turned to a restaurant. You remember in the days of old, 5,000 people were fed with bread and fish, is that not? So this is permitted, is that not? Are we permitted to do it? Okay. So let me have it to you. So, are you beaming? Just be looking at it. Now she is caught. She has to cut the head. Now, unlike Abraham was very lucky. When he took Isaac for sacrifice, you remember an angel just stopped him and gave him, said, you can't don't sacrifice your son, I beg. Now that I know that you obey me now, you know, God began to make promises for him. But in the case of catfish, sorry, Isaac has to die for the sake of thousands of babies. So that's what's happening now. So she's cutting to bring out the testes. Can you see the testes right in there? There are two of them. Sometimes you see some fish with just one. That's not anybody's fault, though. You know, it's God that made them. But what's important is that when you look at the testes is whitish, like cream with milk inside. There are about two of them. Can you see it? You see what she did? Just kitchen knife. Madam, you don't have to go for some serious surgical knife. Oh, no. Just your kitchen knife is okay. You see, nylon bag for 10 naira, isn't it? Lay there. You see tissue paper, right? Isn't it? And then you saw I use blade to cut the tummy. Is that okay? And bring out the testes. Are we okay? Okay, so he's removed the testes now. Now, with the testes out, the next thing now is now make sure you don't touch the testes with normal water. You know, your hands are dry. Do you know why? If you touch it with water, the sperm will quickly begin to swim, and then in about 1 minute, they don't do the assignment. And if there's no egg, that means they are wasted. So you hold on until you have brought out the eggs. So the next thing now, they are going to press out the eggs of the female now. You remember I told you, for the female, we injected it around 2:30 a.m. to make up for 9 hours. If it were you, you don't need to 2:30 for what? Just do your own around 6 p.m. No, sorry, about maybe 9:30, 10. Right? And when you wake up around 6 or 7, you can now wake up to strip. Is that okay? Now be very careful to do it on Friday night. You know, Saturday morning, the eggs will fertilize. Now it will be Sunday when you are at service that the eggs will hatch, and you are supposed to remove unhatched eggs. So don't do it on Friday night. Make it a Thursday or a Saturday. Don't probably do it as a Christian on Friday night. Is that okay? Is somebody hearing me? Nothing. Okay. So they are bringing out the female now. For just watch the screen, and then. So let's hold it. Now where's the water? Do we have water? Where's the bowl? There, bowl. Okay. Now needed again is a bowl. This is from your kitchen now. Oh, for communion, right? But you use one in your kitchen, you know. And that's what they are going to strip the eggs into. Now, before you strip the egg, there's supposed to be what you call incubator. Now, that incubator, when they show a video preview very soon now, the one they were showing initially when Pastor was talking, I will show you how to make a wooden box together with tarpaulin to make your incubator. Is that okay? And you can use a basin, the one they used to bath baby, you know. If your eggs are small, but if your eggs are big, you better make the wooden stuff. Are you getting me? Now, but for this case today, we're going to use, do we have a bowl? What do we use as incubator now? Okay, we'll use one of these bowls. Quickly, can somebody bring us water? We'll just use ordinary water first. But for you, you'll be using energized water later on. Is that okay? So that you can have almost 100% hatching. What kind of water did I say? Energized water. So we'll use that one as a bowl. We don't want those fishes to die for nothing, because we'll still end up having close to 5,000 to 8,000 babies hatch from this. So let's use that bowl. We make what they call an improvised incubator. Now, when I was in the university, you know what they call an incubator? They call it California hatching trough. Now that California hatching trough, it's almost about $400, as far back as 1985. Did you hear me? Now, what does it take to get a basin or a wooden vat that carpenter make for you? You don't spend up to 3,000 naira now, isn't it? Even you can use a big basin. I have these brown ones, right? Those are the things we removed from, the complexity we removed from the system. Now, you will now use what, instead of the grass, you know, there's a stubborn grass that was with it. Once you start, okay, they started pressing the eggs out. Okay, can you see the eggs coming out? I can't hear somebody talk. Can we hear? Okay, good. Now, that is interesting. That is, nobody in the world of fisheries would like to do this for you without collecting 30K or 50K from you. Let's give Jesus a clap for this. I'm not saying you don't do this, though. You charge people, though. Did you hear what I said? You need to hitch. Charge people, oh. Are you getting me, ma? As a matter of fact, ordinary women charge people more than I do. My wife collected 30,000 from somebody yesterday, one woman. I hope she's not here. Well, she has paid advance already. She will say, nah, yeah, they get free now. Bring my money back. But you can do that. Is that okay? Uh-huh. Now look at it. Can you see the heads? Now, to think that each of these things is a baby. Look at how many. If you look at it closely, can you zoom in on it very closely? With the light. Can you see the volume of eggs? This is almost close to 15 to 20,000. Now to think that when they hatch, you are going to sell each one for 20 naira each. That young man, can you calculate for me again? So what they will do now is to now fertilize. The next stage now. So what was done before now is to induce the pregnancy. Now is now to now fertilize the fish. Is that okay? Now can we do something even in the church? You make a business community now. a business, women business center, like it's done in Church of God Mission in Benin. Are you getting me? Create a forum. Begin to produce. That's where women get trained again and again. Is that okay? Put money together. Do that to rehearse, to get it right. And then you cannot begin to move to from your house. Then you cannot begin to move to churches. Is that okay? In this way, you can take care of Gambia. You can take care of South Africa, man. You can take care of Cameroon. Is that okay? I almost wept some 2 weeks ago in a mountain in Okpo, in Benue State. You know this program done by Evangelist Sunday. Okay, they are fertilizing now. See, immediately they put water, energized water, and then they scale it together.
Mr. Now, Fish, what's going on now?
Now, what's going on now? They are fertilizing the eggs. You saw how they put the testes, cut it, and they use water to mix with the eggs. Is that okay? Now, they are going to spread it. They are going to spread it on... Now, this water is not enough, but quickly spread. Now, can we have more water, please? More water. Now, the only thing we did that is not all right here is that our incubator should have been as long as almost two tables. What did I say? Two tables. And then the net, you saw we were cutting the net, but we have to demonstrate for you. Is that okay? So we use this black net, you know, to create the impression, you know, water will be on, you know, water will be floating all over. Is okay, this is the net. Don't use the white net, because when the baby is hatched in about 20 hours or so, you know, some will not hatch, maybe about 5% or so. Now, those ones will decay and they can kill the babies that have hatched. So, if you use a white net, it will not work. Is that okay? Now, don't use the green net and the blue net. Why? Those ones are too big. Both the baby and the, what's it called? The baby and the unhatched egg will go down. So, is this one, they call it aluminium net. Is that okay? Can we call that one? Okay? So, this is an improvised incubator. When we get back to our base, we will go and spread it. Are you getting me? We might have 50% survival here. Do you know why? Because we crammed all of them together, which is not fair. But I think we'll be pardoned here, you know, for doing this. But I think we saw the process. How many of us understand the process? One, aho. Can we clap for Jesus for that? Now, an incubator is something you use a wooden vat. A wooden vat. Can you play? Okay. Can you play that video, Mr. Fish, that TV montage?
Chile.
Are you getting me? So when we get to the incubator, I'll tell you to stop. That TV montage, can you play it? So when you see some green wooden vats, okay, good. Keep playing. And then when we get to the wooden vat, you just pause. We'll pause. Okay? Stop. Good. That's smart. Now, that's a wooden vat. Can you still play it a little bit more? Can you still play it a little more? Can you see? Okay. Okay, stop it again. Now, that's somebody who doesn't want to use normal wood. A carpenter will put 12 by 1, about 5, you know, 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5, and then carpenter put it together. You now buy tarpaulin at Coca and put it there. Make sure you wash the tarpaulin first with dry grass. You soak it with dry grass for 2 days so that the chemical will be off. So you remove the grass after about 3-4 days, and then you wash it with table salt. Don't use any chemical, just table salt for about 10 minutes, you know, like that, dry. You know, the water is not there anymore. Just wash it that with salt. Then you now rinse it, and then you now put new water. The incubator is old. Your fish will be perfect when you now put the fish. Because so many people's problem is that they buy the tarpaulin, they immediately hatch the fish inside. Then the chemicals of the tarpaulin factory will now begin to kill the fish after 48 hours. And they think it's one Satan that is causing that. No, it's ignorance. I hope we're clear about that. Is that okay? Now, the one you saw now is Covenant University VAT. Even at Covenant, oh, this one belongs to somebody in Port Harcourt, Chief Akwana. He wanted something. He's got some cash in his pocket. So he wants something sophisticated so that governor will come and launch the ashram. But you, the governor himself, the King of Kings, will really want to launch your own in your room. with the wooden VAT, you know? So you are on. Are you getting me? Now, if you need... So, after about now, the alarm starts now. This is about 12 o'clock. Now, if you look at the temperature is about 29 degrees. No, 27. water temperature. You know, you put your stuff in the water. Now, if you look at the table, you will see it will take 23 hours for it to hatch. 23 from this time. That means about 11 o'clock tomorrow. This will have become thousands of babies. But we're carrying it away to our place, though. Because you have no big incubator. We will have tell you prepare it in advance. That was a mistake.
It's okay.
So that we will take it off. But don't worry, there will be by the next Prosperity Week, many of you will be the one doing this program. You know, to teach. I thought somebody would say amen. I won't have to do so much talking, and somebody will give a testimonial. I sold fish like I got an order like that, Mr. Adu, for 9 million naira, 1 million fingerlings, you know, 70,000 fingerlings, and so shall be your portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now let me say one thing. This is only popular in Lagos, Abuja, and Port Harcourt. Every other place seems to be traumatized. Do you know how much this thing is sold for? 25, 30 naira. In Benue State, it's about 60. In the north, it's almost 50. In Port Harcourt, I think it's 55 naira for one. Can you imagine that? So you can enter the market, isn't it? How many of us would like to enter the market? Now do one thing for me. Put your name on a sheet of paper. Is that okay? Your name on a sheet of paper and put interested in perfecting fingerlings production. I'll advise you to get that book and maybe the CD to make it clear. Two people can share because it won't go around. Two people can look at, you know, go to your house together now. Instead of to pop nose or to... For once, read Bible finish and then look at the video together. And then, you know, two people, when you... You know, Jesus always sending people out two by two. Is that not? So pair up with somebody so that you can always have that synergy. So that, you know, one person will defer one mistake, Abby. But then two people will defer 10,000 mistakes. Because always share with yourself. You know, they say one will change 1,000. Then two will change tens of thousands away. So your perfection gets better when you partner with somebody. Is that okay? Don't say they will show me uncle. No. People all have their good side and their funny side. But you look at the good side and where you are going. Is that okay? The future. Are you getting what I'm saying? So with this now, tomorrow 11 o'clock, it will be okay. So I can give a hint to some of you. And if we lose quite some, like I said, because they are too compacted, they are supposed to be spread. Are you getting me? Because the unhashed one might affect those ones because they are compacted. But don't worry, it's okay. Now what happens next, quickly, so that I now shift on to the next ones. Now, what happens after this? How do you get it to this size in about 6 to 8 weeks? How do you get it to this size in about 8 weeks? Now, you have to now take care of babies now. And women are specialists in this one. But men, you know, men too, they know, we all need cash too, isn't it? I know the men are not slow. Now, this is about taking care of baby fish now. Now, how do you go about it? Now, human female, they have breasts to breastfeed their babies. Is that not? That's when you give birth to ones, twins. When they are triplets, there's a problem. No, be so. Now, this one, there are about 10,000 babies. How would the mother fish breastfeed them? Now, God is awesome. God gave all of the baby fish, when they come out alive, they all come out with breasts. That breast will last them, the milk in that breast will last them for 3 days. So that time, you will don't roam about to look for food to give them. Is that not? So, note, they will be absorbing the yolk. Can you give me the fingerling book? Give me the fingerling book. I'll show you an illustration of what it looks like. Now, it's like a globe, a bulb under the belly. Then it will be like that. Then after about 3 days, you will see that thing will disappear. That's what they will be eating for the next 3 days. Don't feed them, because if you feed them, you are going to kill them because you pollute your water. They won't eat. They are just breastfeeding exclusively. Oh, so where is the fingerling book? So for 3 days, fingerling book, okay? Okay, the page that has... Now, all these things we did, I hope we saw it in the illustration. They are there in the illustration. Is that, and that's the book, in case so that you can know how to get the book. Now, this is what happens. The egg, now the next phase now. Okay, you want to show somebody? Now, that is the baby with the breast, right? Now, after the third day, what do you give them to eat? That's the next thing now. Now, there's something they call brine shrimp. Now, some of them take egg yolk. you mix, you boil egg, you know, hard boiled egg, right? Then you bring out, the albumen. Are you getting me? You eat the albumen, or do you throw it away? You know the white part of the egg, where you don't boil and finish. You eat that part. And then the yolk is what you now put in an handkerchief. You now squeeze it inside a bucket of water. Then use it to wet your incubator now. After about 2 minutes, you will see them, their head will look black. Their tummy will be white. Their tail will be black. So you have black, white, black. After about 4 hours, if you look at the fish, you will see black, black, black. So what does that tell you? You take the same water again. You just take, you know, like that. After about a minute or two, if you look at the fish, you will see that they are black, white, black. After about 4 hours, you see black, black, black again. Now you do that. Now all of the process is written here from what you do from day one to the 38th day when the fish will be ready for, are you getting me? Don't let me waste time on that feeding. Now the food are very simple, available, are you getting me, in most of these shops now. When we started this thing, my shop was the only shop in Nigeria from 1997 to almost 2001. Then other people came to copy what we sell. And now you have so many shops all over selling fish feeds. All these poultry people, they sell the same thing too. Is that okay? So how do you sell the fish? Now, when you want to sell, once the fish is becoming 4 weeks old, are you getting me? So many people are going to do the growing the fish from finger to adult size. You tell church members, make a small flyer or by word of mouth. Is that okay? Word of mouth. If you have about 3 or 4 daughters, and then you keep them in the room non-stop, will you see anybody talk to them about marriage? No, I can't hear anybody. I'm a typical example of that. Because my mom is very, very closed in person. Our school is opposite her house. So when my dad is a census man, 1963, so he came to count in that house. So when they have left, somebody told them, there's a fine girl in that house that you have not counted. Go back. So my dad went to threaten the man. That's my mom's father now. See, there's a girl here. They said, there's a girl. Bring her out for counting. So they brought the fine girl. The census man looked at the girl and said, came back to count again and again and again. Before you know it, I was born in 1964. My mom told me the story. Now you can imagine if that census man did not go and do census in that house. My mom thought she wanted to be a Catholic nun. She won't marry at all. Thank God she married. Thank God Mr. Fish was produced. So you must advertise.